period of game three, but finished the overtime game on adrenaline. However, the knee has stiffened, and Dan Cloutier gets the start in net for Vancouver. They try to prevent the Avalanche sweep in game four. Here are the highlights.
Danny, oh, Danny boy. Ray, looking not bad in the first.
Well, Brian Burke acquired him because he says he's a goaltender that can be their key to the future. Makes a great glove save on Rob Blake. He's got a quick glove hand. He gets down a little early, but he's got good reflexes. Here on the same power play, Forsberg to Joe Sakic. Again, Cloutier right on his game, right out front of the crease.
No score after one. Let's go to the second period. Sakic. Hey, Duke. Toe save by Cloutier. Great head of hair, Mark Crawford. Later second half, shorthanded Forsberg. Oh boy, Danny. Groovy kind of glove. Tries to play it. Sakic. As the crowd's going wild. Working with Forsberg. Here comes Forsberg. Loses control. Cleared out, and Cloutier loses his lid.
All right, there we have another one of those.
That's a penalty. Barahowski knocks Forsberg down.
And this is my highlight. Relax. Okay, Forsberg knocks down Jovanovski. Now watch this. Comes out of the corner. Drury, best pitcher in the National Hockey League. Good backhand goal, but Forsberg made that play happen behind the net with Eddie Joe.
Now you were supposed to start here.
Oh, I don't have two of them on my shot sheet here, but I'll show it again. Watch right here. Little left to the chops. Jovanovski goes down. Drury picks up the puck, walks out of the corner. Fakes it. Goes to his backhand, puts it in the open net. Best pitcher in the National Hockey League.
Chris Drury is a god. Barry, you're a premature shot sheet reader. Later, Brian Allen hits Eric Messier right into Brendan Morrison. Morrison knee buckles. Hope he's okay. He would not return. And here come the floodgates. 2-on-1. Forsberg whiffs, and somehow it trickles through.
Because he's good.
2-0 Avs. Joe Sakic right in the slot from Tangay.
He's good, too.
Yeah, he's pretty good. 3-0 Avs. Eric.
They mentioned Cloutier goes down too early.
Eric Messier, 3 goals in 38 seconds. Second time Colorado has swept the best of seven. The only other time was when they won the finals back in 96. Sakic, 7 points in the series. He had 9 points in 17 playoff games last year. Chris Drury, 4 goals, 2 assists in the series. He is a hockey god. Avs score 3 goals in 38 seconds. That ties for the second fastest in NHL playoff history. Vancouver's 6th straight playoff loss. They've lost all 3 game 4s when down 3 games to love. Barry, give me a full screen.
Well, I'll tell you, you look at this series and say it was 4-0, so Colorado must have dominated. Not the case at all. Look at the times these two teams were even. 51% of the time, Vancouver and Colorado basically shared the lead very similar times. So it was a tough, hard-fought series. Vancouver's got to be proud of what they've done, especially with Castles out and Naslin out. They're two top goal scorers.
I love when you say at all.
It's a big word in English.
You make it one word. Huge game four.
It is one word.
At all. Wings and
That's
Kings.
An island in the Pacific.
Second period, Red Wings up 2-0, make it 3-0. Kozlov off the stick of Miller. But the Kings start their comeback. Only 6:10 left in the game. They're down 3-0. No way they can win. Scott Thomas, first career playoff goal. It's 3-1. Here's a gutsy move. 2:54 left.
I don't think you agreed with this, did you, John?
You know, I thought it was dicey.
You
but
liar. You didn't agree with it. You were ripping Andy Murray.
I did not rip Andy Murray. Joseph Stumpel makes it 3-2. Take another look at Tall. This is a tough call because you really can't see the puck go across the line until he does that. You're assuming the puck moved up when he moved his pad out. Mark Fossette loves to point at center ice. I figured that out. Under a minute left, 3-2. Trying to hold on, but no! Brian Smolinski, first career playoff goal, ties it at 3. Eric Ballanger loves it on the bench. He also loves it on the ice. Less than 3 minutes in, Ballanger is clutch and clutches everything in life. But whoa, Mick Magoo wants to look at this. We're going upstairs. We're going upstairs. McRae
clearly in here. Ballanger off, off of Osgood, throws it right up under the water bottle, and he's a pretty good pointer, too. I don't know why they're throwing seaweed stuff on the ice, but
that must be like a Red Wing
octopus. That's something to do with the octopus, yeah.
I like it. I like the seaweed.
Octopus, seaweed.
It could be.
Unless there was some bad sushi during the game.
L.A. scores. You say Mick Magoo? Forget it. L.A. scores 3 goals in 5:14.
Lidstrom. You owe Andy Murray an apology.
Lidstrom, a point in all 4 games this series. Fedorov closing in on 100 career playoff helpers. Felix Poffan plays great in playoff overtime, but the man of the hour, the man with the power, Eric Ballanger.
We don't give up. Now the series even, and we're going back to Detroit. Heads up, and we just... We're just happy to be here and get the win tonight and get in a plane tomorrow and get a win on Saturday.
I'd eat 38 shots.
Would you please be quiet? Kings and Red Wings, game five. Series suddenly tied 2 games apiece. ABC has it from Detroit. What's first? Tonight's question. Barry and Ray. Which active player has the most regular season goals without won the playoffs? This is a great question. Which one of these men, no goals?